Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're finally out fishing on Lake Chickamauga. It's been since November since I've been out on the water. Just been staying home with the baby, which I am absolutely happy I get to do, stoked that I get to do. But I'm also really excited to be out here. We're dragging bottom right now. It's all mud. But anyways, just wanted to get out here, do a little bit of fun fishing. We just got finished installing our new Lowrance system. The active target isn't looking too good just because we're in the mud. But we were up at BassBoatElectronics.com in Nashville doing that. They did a great job. And so just wanted to test everything out. And so far, everything is working perfect. Mint. And we've got the new Ghost Troll motor, which I'm really excited about. But anyways, conditions are cold. I'm going to put my rain suit on pretty soon here. It's overcast. I think the air temperature is probably 45 degrees. It's overcast. And the water temps are 50 degrees, right around 50. So anyways, guys, I'm predicting, we catch some on things like lipless crankbaits. I might throw some chatterbaits if we get some good water, shallow diving crankbaits and jerkbaits. Those sort of things should work good today, but we're going to see. We're a little bit rusty. Let's go knock off some of that rust and catch some fish. All right, let's get to it. Little fish. Smallmouth. Oh yeah, come here, baby. Look at this. Nice smallmouth. Ate it good. Red is such a good color for crankbaits this time of year. Once it hits January, I really start fishing more crawfish patterns. Not a giant, but man, lots of fun catching smallmouth like that. So this crankbait, really just like a 4-foot running crankbait. This is the Berkeley Dime. Really good crankbait so far. This is the first day I've actually started throwing it, but it looks really good. It's very similar to like a DT series crankbait from Rapala or something. Rapala. But yeah, just cranking this rock, main river here, pretty much textbook smallmouth territory, that's for sure. Textbook smallmouth territory. But I honestly think now that we're starting to get kind of to a steeper part of this bank, probably can start throwing this jerkbait a little bit. And then once it gets really steep, I think I want to switch over to a spinnerbait. I just did a video about bluffs, and how they set up, and this is a perfect example of a bluff end. This is shallower right here, more sloping contours before you hit where the creek channel hits the wall. And so I could fish that 4-foot crankbait and maintain bottom contact the whole time. But as it starts getting steeper, switch to something that stays in the strike zone a little bit longer. And then once we get real steep, you need something that just kind of crawls down that ledge. And since I'm not in the mood to be throwing, oh, there's a fish right there. Another smallmouth. Another smallie. Whoa, look at that. All right. We're figuring it out. See that? So I switched to the jerk bait. This is a mega bass jerk bait. Little guy. Switched to that jerk bait because it's starting to get a little bit steeper and I don't want to get out of the strike zone too quick. So making like little adjustments like that as the depth changes is really key. And pretty soon, in just a few feet here, I'm not going to be able to fish the jerk bait at all and have any efficiency at all, or it be very effective. Still be efficient, but probably won't get that many bites. So slow rolling that spinner bait is going to probably be better, but we'll find out. Fun. Love it. First day of the year I've been out. Nothing but smallmouth. Oh my gosh, that was a big one. Darn it. I can't remember the last time I broke off on a jerkbait fish. I can feel all kinds of nicks and stuff in the line though. Who knows how old this line is? I just grabbed it out of the rod locker, but that was a big one. That was a big fish. And there goes a $20 gosh darn mega bass. Oh man. What in the heck? Luckily I have another one that's exactly the same. Again, I can feel all the nicks in the line. I've been fishing around a lot of rock, so just not being attentive to my line. Darn it. I'm more angry about the jerk bait. Well, looks like we're gonna have to change out a hook. The hooks I have on here, it looks like this bait's floating a little bit. You don't want your bait to float at all, especially this time of year. So we're gonna go upsize by a tiny bit for that front hook. You know, when fishing a jerk bait, man, it is so important to have the right buoyancy. And sometimes it means, you know, having a neutrally buoyant bait that just sits there perfectly suspended, not doesn't float or sink. And then it's really good sometimes to have a bait that sinks. And very rarely do I want one that floats. But I don't, you know, during the warmer months, I would see that I could see a floating one being a beneficial. Let's see. Still floating, so let's go ahead and change out the other ones too. We got one that's bent anyway, so. Alright. See how that does. Oh yeah, perfect. Just barely sinking. So,
I ended up changing the hooks to the same size, actually, that was already on there. The stock hooks that were already on there. But the Hayabusas are just a little bit beefier. And so they're giving me just a tiny bit of a sink rate, which is exactly what we want. Let's see what we can do with this thing. There's a fish. Spotted bass. Hit it right at the boat. Got a lot of current on this bank here, so I'm not surprised. Where are the big ones? All right. Beautiful fish, man. Dude, the colors and the patterns on bass during the wintertime really pop. It's pretty amazing, especially in clear water. Right here, we're in an eddy, so the current's coming this way, but, I mean, right here, the current's going this way, but the current's supposed to be coming this way. So we got a little eddy action going on. Oh. Another jerkbait bass. Jerkbait is the key today. I've seen that a lot on this lake. You know, where a jerkbait really does play a big role when the current's, you know, current's running this time of year. It's a little bit steep for my taste for throwing the jerkbait right here, but we're gonna try to keep it as close to the bank as possible. There's one. There's one. I think it's another spot or a large, it's a largemouth. Again, right at the boat. First largemouth of the day. Get in here, sucker. Nice chunky one. Dude, this is so much fun. I love it when they get on a jerkbait bite out here. And again, you know, I think that the reason why I'm able to get quite a few bites today, which, you know, we're not like setting the world on fire or anything, but we're getting some bites and having some fun. It is a lot of fun for sure, especially for the first day I've been out in a long time. And you can see here, we got this bluff end. We did that bluff video, and this is a perfect example. This is exactly where the bank starts to flatten out.
All right, everybody. So that's it for today. We didn't blow the doors off of Lake Chickamauga today, but we did have a lot of fun. We caught some fish, and we caught all three species of bass in this lake. Well, there's a fourth one, which is a mean mouth, which is a blend, but spots, smallmouth, largemouth. It was a lot of fun today. And the big player, we did catch one on the shallow diving crankbait, that Berkeley Dime one. But the big player was that mega bass jerkbait that I threw today. And I really think that's because of the current. You know, I've really had a lot of great days out on this lake. When the current's rolling, we had a lot of rain yesterday. And when the current starts rolling like that this time of year, they get on those really heavy current areas, and the jerkbait seems to work extremely well because they're really focused on the shad and stuff like that in those areas. But you know, if it was calm, I'd probably catch more on that colored crankbait or a lipless crankbait or a chatterbait or something like that. But anyways, all of the tackle that I used is going to be in the description below. There's some of them that are going to be affiliate links to 44 Tackle. If you use those affiliate links for 44 Tackle, you can get 10% off your order, and it's a great way to support the channel. So thank you in advance for using those affiliate links. But other than that, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like, share, subscribe. Always trust the process, and I'm going to see you out on the water. Take care.